Hello everyone, my name is David. Today we are going to take a look at another scary story with you. Friends, New Delhi, the capital of India, is considered the city of hearts. Its beauty adds extra charm to India. This place, filled with hustle and bustle, is sometimes also known for places where the old stories of elderly people still linger. Mr. Rudra Prakash, a resident of New Delhi, shares this story with us, telling us that this incident happened during the days of my transfer. Actually, I am a teacher in a government school, and we didn't even know when and where our transfer would take place. In the midst of all this, one day I found out that I had been promoted. With the promotion came more money, but the biggest problem was that I had moved far away from my home. For a month, I rented a room in Delhi, but afterward I couldn't settle anywhere without my family. So I decided to call my entire family to Delhi, and we would buy a nice house here. December 27th was the day when I saw some things beyond my imagination. That day, lost in my own thoughts and wandering around humming my own songs, my phone rang. When I answered, I found out it was a call from within Delhi, from someone wanting to tell me about a house. Actually, I had researched about a house online, and maybe that's why someone got my number and informed me about a house. When I talked to that person properly, I found out that the rent for that house was very low. I couldn't believe that I could find such a good house in such little money. After that, I told the man that I would be off around 4:30 in the evening and then I would head straight home to check out the house. The distance from my school to that house was only about 4 kilometers, so I also liked the house quite a bit. Moreover, the rent for that house was very low. Currently, midterm exams were going on in the school, so I couldn't take leave at this time. Now, it was appropriate for me to see that house at night. When school ended in the evening, I went straight to my room first, changed and had some food, then headed towards that house. I was a little surprised because how could someone offer their house at such a low price? I was thinking if someone was playing a prank on me. It was 6 o'clock in the evening, and slowly the darkness was engulfing the sunlight. In the cold weather, darkness sets in around 6 o'clock in the evening. I was very close to that house the man had told me about. As soon as I reached that area, I was surprised to see that all the houses in that colony were closed. Some people were moving around, but when I tried to talk to them, they all seemed to be in a hurry for some reason. Then I called the man who had given me the address of this house. He said, "Brother, do one thing. Go to flat number 109 in that colony. I will meet you there." After hearing his words, I hung up the phone and headed straight to that house where he had directed me. To be honest, this place felt really strange to me. Whichever way I went, all I could see was silence and emptiness. Then finally, I reached the exact spot where that man had called me. As soon as I reached in front of flat number 109, I saw that the door of flat number 109 was surrounded by dust all around. It seemed like the door hadn't been opened for years. Furthermore, when I focused on that door, I found that there was no lock on it. It was just open. Despite that, no one had dared to touch it until today. I was thinking about this when I heard someone's voice. Actually, I saw that someone had come behind me. As I turned around, I saw that he was a seemingly crazy man, holding a slipper in his hand and doing strange movements. It was quite evident that the man was mentally unstable. Then he said, "You are the one living in this flat." Saying so, he started laughing. I couldn't understand what he wanted to say to me. Then he said, "Just a little longer. Soon everything will become clear." His words didn't seem to make any sense at all. Then, the light from a motorcycle headlight fell directly on the man, and only then did I get a clear look at him. Actually, I saw that the man was wearing torn old clothes. As soon as he saw the motorcycle headlight, he fled from there. After that, the bike stopped next to me. When I looked closely, I found that he was a man with a big beard and mustache. Then he smiled at me and said, "Hello, brother. I understand that you are the same man who called me." After that, we started having casual conversations, and in the midst of it, that man said, "Hey, that foolish guy, what was he saying to you? Did he say anything wrong or disrespectful?" Then I recounted everything that man had said to me. After that, The owner of the flat said, "Oh, brother, what's the matter? That guy living here is a beggar, and his mind is a bit disturbed. He keeps babbling about being an old lover." As soon as he said this, a faint smile appeared on his face. But for some reason, I felt a strange sense behind that man's smile. After that, I didn't pay much attention to that man and started discussing about the flat again. "Friends, at that time I really needed a flat. So, I said to that man, 'Look, brother, the thing is, I need to stay here for a few days to see if this place suits me or not. If you want, I can pay you rent for a month, and then if I like this place, I'll properly buy it.' After hearing me out, the man said, 'All right, as you wish. But there are conditions to stay in this house. If you do anything wrong, then you'll face consequences you never even imagined, and you can't absolve yourself of responsibility.' Hearing the man's words, my ears stood up. Then he mentioned that you don't need to go to the room below this house, which is built in the underground floor here, and never pay attention to the words of that crazy man who says he sends foolish people to their death by confusing them with his words. Apart from that, there are no other conditions for you. If you buy this house, then you can do whatever you want with this house.' After saying this much, that man turned back his steps. I wanted to stay inside this house tonight, but due to the lack of cleanliness, I thought it was better to leave from there. That day, after leaving from there, I returned to my room. But I still couldn't understand what the connection was between the man who looked like a beggar and the room below. As I pondered over these things, I couldn't tell when I fell asleep. When I woke up, it felt like someone had knocked on my room from outside. As I tried to look around my surroundings with my eyes, my body couldn't move an inch. It felt as if someone was lying on top of my entire body. I tried hard, but I couldn't move my neck or my body. Then I looked towards the ceiling, and the scene there shocked me to the core. I had never seen such a terrifying sight before. It was a blackish thing emitting black smoke from within. It felt like there was a shadow looming over me. I had seen such scenes many times in movies. Just then, it fell upon me, and I screamed loudly. As I screamed, my eyes opened, and I immediately sat up in bed. It was the first time I had faced such a terrifying dream in my life. My whole body was drenched in sweat. Despite the cold, my body was drenched in sweat. It felt as if I had been running in intense heat. Now, my body also felt quite exhausted, and it seemed like I was about to get a fever. When I checked the time, it was 2:30 in the night. This terrifying dream had scared me so badly that I couldn't sleep again. So, I just sat up in bed. For a while, I sat there quietly, and then my eyes closed. When I woke up in the morning, I felt my body was completely normal, but when I woke up at night, I also felt a high fever. I thought it was just a bad dream and didn't pay much attention to it. So I ignored it and then went back to see the house. Since today was a school holiday, I could see the house during the day. When I reached the house, cleaning work was going on there. And seeing this made me quite happy because tonight I was going to stay inside that house to see what kind of experience it is inside. After wandering around all day, when evening came, I began to see that same crazy man wandering around again. I was quite surprised to see him because I hadn't seen him there once during the entire day I was there. I was wondering where he suddenly came from when he started running towards me. For some reason, that man seemed very strange to me. Then, as he approached me, he said, "Hey buddy, how was your night?" Hearing this, my legs went weak, because the words he had just spoken were astonishing to me. Just before I could say anything to him, the owner of that flat arrived there. He stopped me in the middle and scolded the man who looked like a lunatic and chased him away from there. But one thing was understood very well, that there were many mysteries buried in that man's mind. That's when the owner of the flat said, "Oh brother, I did tell you that he's a bit eccentric. Don't pay too much attention to what he says. I also wanted to talk to the owner of that flat, but then I thought maybe I misunderstood something. So I ignored it again. As a teacher, I didn't believe much in supernatural things anyway. However, the incident of that night had scared me to some extent. But still, I ignored it. As time passed, everyone in that house had left, leaving only me who could break the silence looming in that house. After ordering food online, I had eaten, but even after that, I felt restless in this house. After that, I went and lay on the bed, and before I knew it, I fell asleep. And suddenly, I felt as if someone's cold hands were touching my body, causing a shiver to run through me. For a moment, when I opened my eyes, I didn't see anyone there, but I was a little scared by this. So I sat up. I looked around, but apart from the dim light of a faint bulb, I couldn't see anything. Then afterward, I got up and reached near the door. As soon as I reached the door, I saw someone sitting on the stairs. He had his head resting on his knees and was sobbing softly. At first, I thought maybe it's that same crazy guy who often wanders around in this society. But then I started to approach him. I don't know why, but now I also began to feel a little uneasy. Then as I approached him, I suddenly touched him. And at that moment, I heard someone running from the side. But when I looked to the side after touching the person, I found that the crazy guy was on the other side. This time his face seemed a little tense. He was sweating profusely. Afterwards, I felt someone had grabbed me from behind. As soon as I turned around, seeing that sight made me lose my senses. The man who had just been sitting in front of me suddenly started appearing behind me and grabbed my shirt from behind. I couldn't understand what I should do at that moment. Somehow, I took a deep breath and then, summoning some courage, immediately tried to push the man away. But you can gauge the strength of that man from the fact that even after exerting all my strength, he remained unfazed. Then suddenly, the man looked upwards, and as soon as he looked up, my eyes widened in horror. Actually, I saw that the man's face was very terrifying, with half of his face covered in animal-like hair and the other half smeared with blood. Without a second thought, I quickly tried to flee the society, but my feet had already started responding. Then I saw a man who looked like a fool. So, I found he gestured with his hands, and I saw a door shining with light towards him. Seeing that door, for a moment I thought this man might trap me, so I shouldn't trust him. But then when I saw that devilish-looking person coming towards me, involuntarily, I ran. I entered through that lit door, and as soon as I entered, I found myself standing outside the society. Truly, this unbelievable thing happened to me, which terrified me terribly. Before I could run, I noticed that the man who seemed like a fool was running towards me. I could have left right then, but there were many questions in my mind. Then that man came to me. "Why, brother, what I said, did it happen or not?" This time, I nodded my head, and afterward, he told me that to learn the secret of that man, I would have to meet him again right here at 12 o'clock midnight. Friends, upon hearing that man's words, I didn't go back to that flat again because I was afraid that my life might be in danger. Now, what was the secret of that flat, and who was that man spreading his terror there? I have no idea, but I never went there again. So friends, that's all there is to this story. How did you find this story? Do let me know in the comments section. And if you're interested in such stories, subscribe to the David Scary Stories channel. Thank you.